See this mouse cursor here? And this mouse that I'm not going to use? Watch this. Hi everyone, Ian here, and today I've got some major new features in Mouseless to show you, as well as some updates on cross-platform development. First though, huge thank you to everyone who supported this effort by purchasing a license or leaving feedback or positive comments. It's been amazing to hear how much Mouseless helps you and how much you appreciate it. It really is a dream come true for me, so thank you. Second, on the cross-platform work, I've got the config editor and overlay working across all platforms, which is pretty much most of the work. And so the Windows beta is on track for release at the end of March, and the Linux and Intel Mac versions not long after that, sometime in April. So to stay in the loop, please hit the bell here or check the description for links to my socials or the email newsletter. Final announcement, country-specific pricing is in effect, and I'll be adjusting prices on March 20-something. So if you want to lock in a lifetime cross-platform license at the current price, now's the time to do so. My goal is simply not to have to go back to a 9-to-5 corporate job, because if that happens, I simply won't have much time to work on Mouseless and other innovative projects. All right, so with that said, there's been some big changes in Mouseless. As you can see, this grid is based on the QWERTY layout. So we have Q, W, E, R, T across the top row. And in the columns, we have Q, A, Z, W, S, X, and so on. And you now have a very quick way to save and load presets. So you can switch between this position-based layout, or you can go column row. So you have the columns in alphabetical order. So go M, then you have the rows in alphabetical order. We'll go J, then you pick a point. We'll go C. And that puts us at the row column layout. So we pick a row, then a column, then a point. And finally, we're at the position-based columns layout. So you have the home row keys as the columns on this one. And here is my normal full position-based one, but for demo purposes, I have kind of a one hand at a time one, so the letters are bigger and it's easier to see. In the current preview version, I've made life a lot easier for those of you who use non-QWERTY layouts or multiple layouts generally. So let's say I wanted to use Greek in my layout. I can just set my system layout to Greek, then hit this button, and now the overlay responds whether I'm in the Greek layout or whether I'm in any layout. I've also added some new features for even faster clicks. First, you can now toggle continuous mode, which lets you click continuously without having to toggle the overlay. And I've also added grid action level. So not only can you click in 3 key presses with the subgrid, but you can click in just 2 key presses or even just 1. The next big feature is full mouse wheel capability. To use it, simply tap the Alt key and then use the home row keys to scroll and the Command key to go faster. And there's also step scrolling for more precise increments. Another new feature currently in beta is the ability to use mouse buttons without bringing up the overlay. So you can still control the mouse cursor with the mouse or trackpad or trackball and tap a key to do your clicking. This is useful for preventing or alleviating repetitive strain injury, like carpal tunnel, tendonitis, or for maintaining precise position or movement while clicking, which might be useful in artistic or gaming or certain design contexts. Also, personally, if I'm on a laptop, I just prefer the way this feels over tapping or clicking with the trackpad. There's also several new style options, including the ability to set the font. And there's some new line styles to help increase visibility. So we have dots, and we have dashed. Now, for those of you with multiple monitors, Mouseless does have you covered. You can just move the overlay between monitors with taps of the shift keys. I know you can't see it, but trust me, it's happening. And if you want to assign different grid configs to each monitor, you can do that with this field. But for most of you, even if you have a mix of vertical and horizontal monitors, the auto setting and the presets probably mean you don't have to configure this manually. So that's a quick rundown of the latest and greatest features in Mouseless. I'll be putting up a more in-depth tutorial soon to cover all the settings and commands in the config editor. There's a lot more innovation to come, including a new algorithm for super precise, super fast clicks, as you can see here in this prototype. Mouseless already saves time by preventing hand movement between the keyboard and mouse, and excels when coordinates can be memorized or even just estimated ahead of time. But with this new algorithm, Mouseless will rival mouse usage even with continuous, spontaneous click targets. And as soon as I have a break from Mouseless, I'm going to finish and open source my design for this keyboard mod with a full tutorial and revive my long dormant music production software, Sonescape Studio, to go along with it. So, if you want to see more, please hit the bell, and if you purchase a license or simply want to donate through the Buy Me a Coffee link below, it's a big, big help, and I'm super grateful. Thanks, everyone. Happy clicking.